A group of students from Makerere University, led by Joshua Lowell Muhwezi, made their way to Parliament with a petition addressed to the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, expressing their grievances over the stalled Students Guild elections.
Make sure that we get good leadership. Maybe just to put this in context is that following the violence that characterized the last guild election, the university found it more plausible to put a halt on the guild election itself.
Makerere University elections, which were meant to take place on July 15, 2022, were suspended following violent campaigns in which a UCU student, Michael Betungura Bewatte, was stabbed to death. Students claim university management is capitalizing on the bad incident to disenfranchise students from electing leadership.
As we realize that it was necessary for the council to take necessary steps to make sure that we have a transparent guild election, we also feel that they are taking advantage of the situation to abuse the university policies and regulations, hoodwinking the public that this is a measure to discipline and to restore the sanctity of the students' guild.
The resolutions of council did not have so much to do with what happened. All the unfortunate incidents, but that has so much to do with the politics at Makerere University. Right now, we suffer lack of management, but we suffer a sufficiency of politicians as managers of the university.
Makerere is a hill of intellectual exchange. Students should not be treated like kids. These are adults. We all regretted the incidents in which we lost a young man.
The group accused the Makerere University Vice Chancellor, Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, for taking advantage of the absence of a functioning guild council to manipulate things and remain at the helm of the ivory tower.
So we feel that the Vice Chancellor is deliberately refusing to restore the guild leadership, just not to have any disturbances as he advances his interest to retain office.
On receiving their complaints, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, put police to task to fast-track the investigations into the murder of the UCU student, Bewatte, and have perpetrators prosecuted.
Makerere should investigate with security who killed that young man. And Makerere should not join the chorus of rumor mongers for an investigation report. The last we can hear over university is trying to be part of rumor mongering. A death occurred, an avoidable death. There should be a proper investigation without anybody predetermining the outcome.
Mpuuga also warned the Makerere University Chancellor, whose term is expiring in 1 month, that they will not tolerate any of his attempts to remain in office beyond his mandatory age.
The culture of people wanting to hang in on office, even when legally their tenure has expired, is becoming a culture here. And it's our duty, all of us, to reject that kind of culture. I hope the Vice Chancellor has the minimum decency not to amend his age, but also know that that university is not about him.
The search for the new vice-chancellor is yet to kick off as the term of the current vice-chancellor expires soon. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.